Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. But for real, first video here. Heading to the gym, but first.
Fit Radio guys, shout out to Fit Radio. You know what it is, some awesome mixes on there. Just wanna make this video to go over my training, what I'm doing now. A lot of people ask if I go to the gym every day, which I don't. I wish I could, but yeah, my training is still CrossFit style, constantly varied. Meaning, I don't specialize in anything, but I'm pretty good at everything. And I've always been like that, even before I knew what CrossFit was. I've always done some kind of like campy classes. Yeah. Warming up, this whole beginning part is me warming up. I used to skip warming up, meaning I would just run 400 meters or a mile. And I'd be good, but now I have to stretch either my hips, but now I have to mobilize my hips, my shoulders, pretty much everything, just so I don't get injured. I used to always have clients and members ask why I don't warm up personally when I work out, even though I would have them warm up for a good 10-15 minutes. Yeah, learned the hard way, so now, good 15-20 minute warm up. Power plate is awesome for the hips, well, for my hips. I pretty much use it everywhere up now. So I'll do a hinge to squat and then just an air squat. I'm slow. Sometimes I'll stay at the bottom for 20-30 seconds if I need to. But yeah, I always front squat, or now I usually front squat, back squat, deadlift, or push press, push jerk. I'm not really strict pressing now because of my shoulder injury, but I could get away with push press and push jerk. It's kind of weird, but anyways, I'll always have one of those in mind. If my hips, my knees, my lower back, or my shoulder aren't feeling it when I'm working it, then I'll skip and try to do something else. So front squats here, I got away with 225 for 5 sets of 3. I think I only recorded like 3 sets though. I'll try to work the angles for you guys. It's funny because I was going heavier earlier this year, but yeah, things happen. I took a little break from the gym, where I would go like once a week, maybe twice a week. Yeah, I'll usually wear a belt when it starts getting heavier, and for me now, about 185, maybe 205. For front squats, even on back squats, which I could go a little bit heavier. I just started back squatting and deadlifting. Yeah. I'm recording this after, guys. I think I do muscle-ups in this video. Pretty sure I do, but I ripped it off. You can see. Normally, whenever I get blood blisters, I'll peel it off if it doesn't peel off already. Just because, from experience, I know it'll heal faster like this. So makeshift wraps. I have wraps somewhere, the Rage ones, I just don't know where they are. Yeah, muscle-ups are here. The first time I did muscle-ups was probably a month ago. This year, I believe. And I did 3 sets of 3. And then a couple weeks ago, I did 4 sets of 4. And then this workout was 5 sets of 5. So it was 5 overhead squats plus 5 muscle-ups. Overhead squats I haven't, well I have, but strength portion, I believe I did 7 sets of 10, a workout a month or so ago, but that was just strength portion, just those 7 sets with a good like 2 minutes in between. This time for whatever reason, I was really struggling. You'll see me kind of fix my foot. Yeah, there you go. I think I did that almost every set. It's so much different when you're out of breath, trying to do a strength movement, as opposed to when you're just doing strength.
Fifth round of that muscle up overhead squat.
Yeah, last round.
These guys weren't working so much. A little rip going. I stopped it on my third rep.
Yeah, that fifth round, I felt the skin start to rip off my hand. If you've done muscle-ups or butterfly pull-ups or toes to bar, you'll know what that feeling is. I kind of let go of the bar and almost fell off. I held on, dropped down, and cut that last set of five in the third rep. So I felt it on these as well, too, I think I say it. It's an awkward feeling having the fit skin peeling off. So out of breath here. There's another video I'll probably post on Instagram that I never realized how much of a zombie I look like when I'm in between workouts, just dying. Yeah, I split this eight into two sets of four. I was so out of it, I forgot to switch the GoPro around for the wall balls. Yeah, there you go. Came back for it. I posted a couple weeks ago, if anyone struggles with recording their workouts, recording whatever. And it's kind of hard, but just gotta do it. If you want to do it, if you're trying to do it. It gets kind of annoying sometimes. I think that one I was gonna go straight for the wall balls because I wasn't too happy about splitting that set of eight into two sets of four. And then I remembered the GoPro, so I went back for it, and then it kind of just took me out of the zone. So if I remember correctly, I almost get knocked in the face with this wall ball. So the rig here, the ball doesn't hit the target perfect and it comes straight down, it'll bounce off a little like chunk that's hanging off the orange part. There you go. And it shoots at you on the way down. Probably zoom in on it for you guys. But yeah, I almost took my face out. Try to keep it going. I think I started struggling at the end. Yeah, there you go. The lactic acid starting to build up.
My conditioning part number two done. Just did 8 power cleans, 20 wall balls. I did 3 rounds. My legs starting to feel in my legs now. Still have it ripped in my hand.
Yeah, you can see the blood going in there.
I can feel it every rep, so see where I'll do next.
I wanted to do some dumbbell work, or a single arm dumbbell work, but with the rip, it just wasn't going to happen. So I believe it did 3 rounds or 5, I don't remember. 300 meter row, quarter mile bike. It's one of those workouts where your legs, you go into the gym with your legs already super sore and you just pound legs. I'll fast forward through all this. Yeah, that's pretty much my training. I always have some kind of strength or two. Sometimes I'll split those strength up, so I do one strength, meaning squat, deadlift, back squat, or even overhead squat or push jerk, push press, and then I usually try to do a couple conditioning workouts now, if not 3, like this one, which could be anywhere from a quick 5-minute workout to a longer 30-minute workout, as far as conditioning. And I really look back at what I've done during the week and what I'm gonna plan for tomorrow. So if I've done rowing already, if I did rowing yesterday, or if I did this workout today, tomorrow wouldn't have any of these movements at all, or maybe one or two of them, but set up differently. So like this one where I'm rowing and using the bike, instead of 300 meters I'd probably go 100 meters really fast on a rower, or I would go 1,000 meters at a slower pace. Same thing on a bike. Instead of a quarter mile I would probably go for calories instead of distance. like get 10 calories as fast as I can, or try to go 50 calories, maybe at a slower pace. But yeah, guys, probably be posting a lot more training stuff, so if you have any questions, let me know. Take care.
Rips there.